There's another in town somewhere beneath the Forbidden Sands.
A half-goofer? I haven't seen one since I was a child. Lead the way.
I've been studying, and I can forge some new equipment for you. What can I make for you? Anything for Freya? What do you need? I'll disinfect my tools. Anything more to discuss? Let's see.
death had cured me of my appetite. But damn if I can't stop thinking about the smell of deer stew. Awakened a fair few culinary cravings, did. Black pudding, haggis and neeps, oh!
Porridge and honey.
What about you, brother? Any pre-Fimble winter foods you're aching for?
Olives.
The hell's an olive? You have survived a giant's corpse to stop a certain fight we won't talk about. Could you call on that power again?
Maybe. Do you have a massive giant's corpse for me to revive?
No.
Well, there you go. Much of the sand has been cleared away, but another storm rages beyond that pass, which must mean...
Another Hafgufa!
Odd. It looks as though the Light Elves sealed off this section of the Barrens. Why?
Luckily for us, a very considerate goddess has enhanced our magic chisel, and we can unseal it.
My. That is lucky.
The Forbidden Salves lay beyond.
Contested territory, according to Bela. And another storm to endure.
Remember when Freya and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing Hafgufa. But I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim.
Ah! we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave!
I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet, once this Hofgufa is free. This architecture... it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive matter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track, then.
What kind of hive material is sensitive to smell? How odd. When I last came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was covered by hive matter.
Aye. And as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trapped Hofgufa for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
Too thick for that. Maybe the Twilight Stone on the ground will help. There you go.
Behind you, Kratos!
Go!
Travel underneath the Barrens, do they?
Territory changes hands often in Alfheim, or so it appears.
Bigvir did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corpse below would disagree. Good eye. Let's continue, shall we?
Yeah.
Captain, right side!
Them to breed again. It was a dazzling display once. The skies of Alfheim filled with their song.
I imagine it's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate.
Whoops!
wonder if these two comprehend the choice they face once free.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hofgufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
And without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for in the end. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Well, given another chance, I know what choice I would make. There's some Twilight Stone.
Back to the surface, then.
Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
Fate of these creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such a power. So the blacksmith used the flame.
Kratos, is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but. Well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
Well, at least it's a relatable story.
appears we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim. Yet again.
Take solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. Even these creatures know there is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they. Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens? Freya, I've always wondered, why was Freya so revered here so quickly upon his first arrival?
Well, to begin with, it wasn't his first arrival. Very few know this, but Freyr was one of the earliest visitors to Alfheim, back in the dawn of realm travel.
Oh? Bit before my time. Tell.
We believed for a long time that all the giants had died in the Flood, until one of them appeared in Vanaheim. Her name was Gerd, and she came offering to teach us the secrets of traveling between realms using Bifrostlight. Freyr became immediately infatuated with her. He always yearned to wander, and along came someone who could truly show him how. So, wander they did, exploring the world tree from root to branch. But one day, it came time for Gerd to wander away. Freyr was heartbroken, and resolved himself to perform some great feat to win her back. He set his aim on the grandest of gestures. He intended to be the first to find the elusive source of Bifrost Light. And he succeeded, although quite by accident. Freyr believed he navigated best while fortified by a potent blend of Vanir herbs. When he wandered, he wandered. And he managed to wander from the World Tree directly into the Lake of Souls. The elves have never seen anybody come out of the Lake of Souls, so it got some attention.
Oh, that is bloody hilarious.
I don't know whether he worked his charms at that point, or they just assumed him to be a great deity. But of course, he hadn't made this journey in search of responsibility, so he didn't stick around long. Still, the legend of his manifestation was passed along through the ages. It even endured after the Great Division, remembered by Light and Dark Elf alike. So when at last he returned, he was uniquely situated to gain the trust of both sides and help to create a truce. The problem was, both sides trusted only him. So the peace could only last as long as he stayed around to keep it. And with the long war dragging on without an end in sight, I suppose making any kind of peace was an irresistible notion for him. Even if it meant having to rule.
Yeah.
Kratos, tell me of an adversary from your homeland. It will serve us well if I understand more of your battle tactics.
There was Medusa, Queen of the Gorgons. Her gaze turned men to stone. Ymir would turn her own powers against her. Or you may remove her head, but that is the hard way.
Which did you choose?
The hard way.
Forget I asked.
Freya, here.
A dawn bloom. You have an interest in botanicals now?
Another sleeping troll, courtesy of the dwarves.
Brother! Get up, brother!
Oh!
A light elf statue in the desert. Odd.
On top of ancient elven ruins? I'd have to agree.
Don't waste it!
attack!
The magic draining out of all of us has to end up somewhere.
Ever written poetry of your own, brother?
No.
Well, ask a stupid question. put it on one of my horns. Let's see if I can pull it off.
No.
Archive of knowledge.
No sign of the Light Elves.
For now.
Maybe they've left for the day, and we can browse at our leisure.
Look here.
So, these are the Valin schematics, eh?
You know of him?
Aye. One of the most gifted dwarven smiths around. Until he developed a conscience, anyhow.
These texts alone are not enough to end the Elven War. But restricting their access only serves those who wish to prolong it.
Taking a page out of it?
Aye. Quite the advantage for the Light Elves.
All this knowledge of their ancestors, their shared history, poetry, just sitting here, forgotten. What a waste.
Sealed, but there is an inscription. The console.
Bigvir spoke of an exile of the same name. Odds are he'd like a gander at that particular text. Ah, it appears the librarian would like a word.
Lata Framborg.
Sounds like she wants that journal back.
No.
Shield strike now!
It's a fine mess.
Thank you. Right, brother.
Use a shield strike!
Helga brought it up.
She thinks she's protecting them by hiding all this knowledge away.
Our ally wishes to read this journal. We are taking the book.
I'm impressed. Thought you were going to end her.
When last we traveled here, after Fae passed, I killed an elf of great importance. The ramifications were dire for his people. I do not wish to make the same mistake twice.
An entire mausoleum.
They killed their own to protect their secrets.
That's harsh.
It is their way. But perhaps with the Consul's journal, Bigvir can teach them otherwise.
Brother, get up! Brother!